What's going on YouTube? This is Sean. I am back again. And in this video, we are going to be working on the Antman helmet. Yeah, I've been getting a lot of requests for this helmet. So, I figured, you know what? I might as well just do it. I mean, why not, right? And as you can tell in the background, I got the Wasp. I mean, if you're going to make one, might as well make the other, right? But let's just go ahead and jump right into this build. I've already got my templates printed out, and I'm going to cut it out with my high-tech razor blade. And here are the templates laid out. Now, I did go and make some changes to the templates, but you'll see here later on in the video. I'm starting off with my eyepiece, which I'm going to extend the patterns out just about a quarter inch. This will glue underneath the faceplate, which is this piece right here. I'm going to use 5mm craft foam for most of the build. I mean, that's what I do for most of my helmets. Now I'm gonna transfer over the undercut, which is actually gonna be traced out on the underside. That's why we call it the undercut. And then I'm going to cut out the lines for the ear tannas. That way, when we glue the ear tannas on there, they're symmetrical, because you know, we don't want them to be all crookedy. And now that I got my undercut lines all drawn out, I'm going to use my wood burner with a spatula tip, and I'm going to go two pass. And while the foam is still hot, melted, when I fold it together, they're going to fuse together. So this means I don't have to do any V-groove undercuts and glue the pieces together. But you can make some V-groove undercuts if you don't have a wood burner. But if you don't, I highly recommend you pick up one, or maybe two. Nah, you just need one. Now that I got all my pieces all cut out and sort of shaped, I'm going to apply contact cement to the edges. And some areas require glue on the inside, because other pieces will be glued underneath, just to give it that staggering look. And now that I got my contact cement applied, I gotta let it sit and dry to attack, because contact cement only works when it's dry. And here is the nose piece, or the tip of the mouth. And here is the eye piece that I'm applying contact cement. Both these pieces will be glued underneath the faceplate. Now I like to apply contact cement to all my pieces, that way when they all dry to attack and ready to glue together, I can just go ahead and glue everything together without having to stop. So I'm going to start by doing the tip of the mouth, which is these two center pieces. I'm going to carefully align the center piece and start from there, and then once I get that piece glued together, it's time to glue the lower chin skirt thingy, something like that. Well, you get the idea. And then once I have that piece all glued together, we're gonna set this aside so that way we can glue the main pieces, or the front piece together. This is the side and the forehead. I'm going to use the surface of my table to make sure all my seam lines are nice and smooth. Some of you guys are watching my videos and you're thinking, Sean, are those really your hand? Because they're like really stubby. Well, these are hands of a hardworking man. These hands have been through years of working on aviation and building race cars, and now I'm doing cosplay. Notice that I missed some areas right here where I forgot to apply some glue, but that's okay. I can always go back and apply glue and just let it sit. So far, I've got the two main pieces merged together at the forehead. Now it's time to carefully align the nose piece. Now I did cut the center line for the nose in an inward angle cut. That way when I merge them together, they will bevel a little bit. Now it's time to carefully align the tip of the mouth. Now notice I am just putting it on there, not really pressing it in. With contact cement, when you apply pressure, that's when they like really hold down. So try not to apply pressure until everything is nice and aligned, and then push everything into place, and then the contact cement will hold itself permanently. Then I'm gonna put the eyepiece. I'm gonna fold that piece in half and carefully align the center pieces to the seam line, or the center seam line of the mask. And then I'm gonna carefully align the inside lines of the eyepiece to the edges of the faceplate. Now the foam will require you doing some stretching and some compressing in certain areas in order for it to line up, but you have to do this for it to actually take its shape. Sometimes people will tell me, hey Sean, your hash marks, they're not lining up when I'm gluing them together. Well, you have to think about it. You're starting off with a flat piece of foam and you're trying to curve things and make a shape out of it. So it does require that you do some stretching and some compressing in some areas. So here are the pieces that's going to form the back of the helmet. I'm going to start by working on one side by gluing one half of the center top to the side piece. And then I'm going to close up this little gap right here. And then I'm going to put the ear circle thingies right on top of it, just like that. And you should have something that looks like this. And now I'm going to repeat the process with the other side, and this should mirror the piece that I just made, because it's for the other side of the helmet. And you want to make sure that all your contact cement or your foam pieces are pressed together nice and neatly, because sometimes I'll forget to double check and then catch it after I had sprayed a couple coat of plastic dip, and then it's too late to fix it. But you can always go back and put some quick silking on there to seal the deal. And again, I use the surface of my table to make sure all my seam line is nice and smooth. And once you get the two pieces put together, it should look something like this. Now that everything is all groovy, let's go ahead and merge the faceplate to the back half of the helmet. I'm going to start by aligning all the corners, making sure that I don't go and press in the in-between pieces. That way I can go ahead and make sure that all my corners are lined up. And then once I get the corners lined up, I'll go ahead and merge the center pieces by carefully, you know, pressing the pieces together just like that. Now really don't apply the pressure until everything is all nice and lined up and on there. And once I get everything all looking legit, then I will go in and apply pressure and make the contact cement stick permanently. So far, so groovy, and I'm starting to dig what I'm cooking. I hope you're digging it too. Now it's time to apply some of these accents and the ear cannas. I'm using some floor mats for the accent pieces because it's a little bit thicker, and that's kind of what we're going for. And if you're wondering where to get these floor mats, you can buy those flexible rulers, and these floor mats come with them for free. And this is what the first layer of the ear tanner is looking like, and then this is what the second layer of the ear tanner, which I use, I think 8mm EVA foam, but you can use floor mat for that piece too if you don't have 8mm. Now I'm going to take my sandpaper and I'm going to scuff down the texture side. I'm not actually going to sand it all completely down. I just need to make sure that the contact cement will absorb into the foam. Then I'm going to apply contact cement to the surface of the EVA foam. That way I can glue the additional accents. Then I'm going to go in and apply contact cement to the side of the helmet, and also hit the ears too. I did kind of go overboard with the contact cement on the side of the face because I don't know why. And then I forgot to apply contact cement to the surface that I just sanded down. But no biggie, I went and applied some contact cement, allow it to sit and dry to attack, and then carefully aligned it to the helmet. And it should look something like this. Now when gluing these ear tanner pieces together, you want to do one layer at a time. That way you're not actually gluing one really thick piece of foam to the helmet. You kind of want it to take shape as you're gluing them down. Now as I was gluing the other side down, I noticed that one foam was a little bit longer than the other, and it kind of hung over the nose piece. And I thought I could take a pair of scissors and cut it, but no, it's not gonna happen. But I did eventually go back and trim it down with a razor blade. Right there you see it's kind of uneven, but I was able to go back and trim everything down and it looked pretty legit. Well, good enough for me. I mean, it's just cosplay, bro. Now it's time to lay down some paint, but before I do that, I went and heat sealed it, and then I'm gonna apply a couple coat of plastic dip. And here lately I've been using plastic dip more than Mod Podge or the other stuff That's just because the weather is nice outside and Plasti Dip doesn't take too long for it to dry. But I did wait overnight and allowed it to dry, make sure everything was, you know, good enough, and it dried to this really cool matte finish. Now, since breathing is kind of a thing and can't really live without air, I decided to go and burn some hose into the nose piece right there, because, you know, breathing, I mean, I guess, right? I mean, everybody's doing it, might as well. I'm using a wood burner with a sharp tip and plunging it right into there. It kind of gave it a really cool accent, and some of y'all might think I did go a little overboard, but you know, too much air ain't gonna hurt, right? I got this little turntable for, you know, cake, but I'm using it to paint my helmet and play spin the helmet by myself, if that's even a thing. Now I'm going to apply some sterling silver paint to this. I did thin it down with some water and try not to go too thin, but you don't want it thick either, because you do want to feed it through an airbrush. You could always brush it on, but the sterling silver works really good through an airbrush on this gray primer. And this is just the first coat, but after the second coat, everything started to come together. And then I'm gonna paint the back half of the helmet in matte black. And I'm just going to use a regular paintbrush because of, you know, overspray and stuff like that. I even hit the side of the ear pieces, and yeah, everything is starting to look pretty legit. Then I went in and drew in some lines, because right around here, he's got this red area. I guess we'll call them racing stripes, because, you know, why not, right? I thought about doing some weathering and some shading, but I figured, you know what, I'm just going to leave this one as it is, like mint. Now that I'm done with the painting, it's time to address the eyepieces. I'm using this screen looking thingy. I think it's for knitting or crocheting, I'm not sure, but I got it at Walmart in the craft section. I'm gonna apply some hot glue to the inside, and I'm gonna carefully press the mesh right into the area. Now, try not to touch the hot glue while it's still hot, because it's not very smart to do that. I mean, I did touch it a little bit and it hurt. And little did I know this would be the last time I ever use this hot glue gun, because it does explode on me in 3, 2, 1. I mean, that scared the bejesus out of me. Let's watch that again in slow-mo. This is like the second time that's ever happened to me, and man, it scared me each time. Notice I just grabbed the helmet and decided to run for it. But anyways, and here is the final product of my Antman helmet. I hope you guys are digging it. And if you're really into this kind of stuff, then make sure you swing by my Etsy and snag you some templates, because that would really help me out. And if you wanna get some supplies, make sure you check out my Amazon influencer shop, because that also helps me out too. Links will be in the description down below, and make sure you guys tune back in for the Wasp video, because that's coming up, and I know some of you guys or ladies are really looking forward to that. Don't forget to like, share, and comment, because I really dig it. And I guess that's it for this video. I'll see you guys in the next one.